będzie pochwalony Jezus Chrystus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome everyone to the celebration of the Holy Mass. Today is the first Sunday of Lent, and today's Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Robert Burke. So let us just take a moment to prepare ourselves to enter into these sacred mysteries by acknowledging our sins. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my goodness and sisters, thy great sin, my thoughts, my words, from what I've done, from what I've failed to do, my fault, my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God formed man out of the clay of the ground and blew into his nostrils the breath of life, and so man became a living being. Then the Lord God planted a garden in Eden in the east and placed there the man whom he had formed. Out of the ground the Lord God made various trees grow that were delightful to look at and good for food. With the tree of life in the middle of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Now the serpent was the most cunning of all the animals that the Lord God had made. The serpent asked the woman, "Did God really tell you not to eat from any of the trees in the garden?" The woman answered the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden. It is only about the fruit of the tree in the middle of the garden that God said, you shall not eat it or even touch it, lest you die." But the serpent said to the woman, "You certainly will not die. No, God knows well that the moment you eat of it, your eyes will be opened and you will be like gods, who know what is good and what is evil." The woman saw that the tree was good for food, pleasing to the eyes, and desirable for gaining wisdom. So she took some of its fruit and ate it, and she also gave some to her husband who was with her, and he ate it. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they realized that they were naked, so they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be
God. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sin, cleanse me.
Be merciful, Lord, for we have sinned.
For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is before me always. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight.
Be merciful, Lord, for we have sinned.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Be
inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, though sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin, after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one, the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many? And the gift is not like the result of the one who sinned. For after one sin, there was the judgment that brought condemnation. But the gift, after many transgressions, brought acquittal. For if by the transgression of the one, death came to reign through that one, how much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and the gift of justification come to reign in life through the one, Jesus Christ? In conclusion, just as through one transgression, condemnation came upon all, so through one righteous act, acquittal and life came to all. For just as through the disobedience of the one man, the many were made sinners, so through the obedience of the one, the many will be made righteous. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To be tempted and with God's help to overcome those temptations. Now, what Jesus lived, he lived as an example for all of us. And the temptations that we just heard described were things that were done deliberately to him, because we see at the very beginning that he was led into temptation by the Holy Spirit. I believe he was, at this point, he's just been baptized, and so he's around the age of 30, and so he's led by the Spirit into the desert for these temptations. And so, temptations will come to us. Sometimes they're obvious, and we can overcome them easily. Sometimes they're very subtle. Oftentimes, temptations will come when we're vulnerable. Satan is, well, for one thing, he does exist, and so do the millions of demons and all the different angelic choirs and hierarchies having their negative mirror image, if you will. You have the one ascending all the way up to the seraphim, and then you have the opposite going down with Satan and the demons. Angels and demons, their fallen counterparts, who used to be angels, they're pure will, they're pure intellect. And so they're not people. Once they make a decision, it is permanent, it is forever. And so that explains the situation and this rebellion in heaven that we see described in Scripture. Now, we're created in the image and likeness of God, something that angels do not have, but they are superior to us, and they are much, much more intelligent than we are. Demons, I've read by exorcists and demonologists that they're not able to read our minds, but they're able to discern what we're thinking very easily, simply by perceiving the faces we make, our eyes, our mouths, what we say, etc., etc. We have, you know, even a discerning FBI agent knows how to read body language in a very in a way that betrays the person who's trying to conceal secrets. So that is the situation that we're in. Satan does not play fair. Satan is pure evil. He is completely divorced of love and of any echoes of love, because all of that comes from God and is God. And so he will kick us when we're down. He will attack us when we're vulnerable, when we're most vulnerable. He isn't only interested in making us suffer out of sheer hatred, because just as we cannot understand his intellect, his will, because they're not human, we cannot understand his hatred, because his hatred is far surpasses any human hatred, and we know that human hatred can be quite extreme. So he not only wants to see us suffer, but he wants more than anything else to see us damned for all time, to see us condemned to hell along with him. And so he uses temptations, and particularly, you know, like I said, sometimes the temptation, depending on the demon that's tempting us, can be quite obvious and can be easily dismissed. But the higher the rank of the demon, the more powerful and the more subtle the ways up of operating will be. Remember the temptation of Eve. It was very subtle, and it was an appeal to her sense of pride and her sense of fairness. He does the same thing with us. Appeals to our sense of pride and our sense of fairness, and often we don't even realize we're being tempted in most cases until it's too late, until we have acted on those temptations, until we have sinned, and usually in these cases, mortally. So while temptation is helpful, and as we see, Jesus was led into temptation by the Holy Spirit, It's not something that we ask for. On the contrary, lead us not into temptation. We have trials, we have temptations, both can strengthen our soul. But temptations are very dangerous because, you know, if a trial is not overcome, we don't grow in holiness, but okay, that's not too bad. But if we fail at a temptation, we have to go to confession as soon as possible. And not only that, but we have to extricate ourselves from the sin. Sometimes a sin is very difficult to pry oneself out of. So today, as we enter, today's the first Sunday of Lent. So if you missed that Ash Wednesday, don't worry about it. It's not a day of obligation. Today is the first Sunday of Lent. So today, let us ask the Holy Spirit to really give us more discernment. You know, we'll never be as smart as the demons are, but we also have angels on our side. And most importantly, we have Jesus, we have his church, we have the sacraments. May we have the wisdom to use these sacraments often, particularly that one over there, confession. May we make use, frequent use of confession. And may the Holy Spirit give us discernment to detect the subtleties of Satan and to know that we have, he might be smarter than us alone, but never smarter than us when we are equipped with everything that Jesus gives us. May we remember this, and may we make ourselves available to the sacraments, to confession, to communion, and to continue fighting the good fight always with God's help. And especially, may we always remember to pray that rosary every day and avail ourselves of the help of our Blessed Mother. With their help, not only can we win the struggle, but it will be actually relatively easy. God bless you all.
Physically, mentally, spiritually, we pray to the Lord.
men and women in uniform. And let us pray also for all those who have struggled to get by day here in the United States, for homeless. Let us pray for those who are mentally ill and are either institutionalized or living out on the streets. Let us pray for those who despair, for those who live in the clutches of anxiety, depression, addiction. We pray for them.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every person who has asked us for prayer, for the souls in purgatory, and for the repose of the soul of Robert Burton, for whom we offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass this morning, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And I have this Mass intention today from Bishop Rosansky, which is for the Catholic Life Conference, and we pray for its spiritual success. So let us pray that we may follow Jesus' example in the Gospel, resisting the temptations of this world by living out fully our faith, and for all those who will be attending our Diocesan Catholic Life Conference later this month, that they may learn of our Savior's grace and presence. Let us pray to the Lord. Loving Father, we come before you with all of our needs, spoken, unspoken, acknowledged, and otherwise. And Father, as we commence Lent, we ask you to help us in every way. We ask all these things as always, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. And so, for the company of angels and saints,
We sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as what you are pleased to accept, the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, that all receive in Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them on us.
Thank you. 20. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Renewed now with heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have a series of announcements. The Catholic Life Conference, which I alluded to earlier, wants to remind everyone that it is time to register for the March 21st conference. A sign-up sheet is in the vestibule for people who want to ride, since it is down in Springfield. And we are looking into getting a bus. So please register. This is a great blessing for our parish and for the whole diocese to have this great opportunity to learn more about the faith and to have these great speakers like Trish Short and Scott Hahn. This really is a milestone event for us. Vespers are not being celebrated at all during Lent, but they will resume, God willing, after Easter. Today we will have the chanting of Rosh Kazale at 2 p.m. and will continue every Sunday of Lent. If you're not familiar with this, it's a Polish tradition. Rosh Kazale means of the bitter lamentations, and we receive booklets that have the Polish text, but also the English translation. And it really is a beautiful and moving way to deepen one's gratitude for what our Lord has done for us. So please come and take advantage of this opportunity to meditate on the passion of our Lord. This Friday, the 6th of March, is First Friday. So we will have the traditional Latin Mass at 5:30, the Trinitatis Mass. And we will also have our all-night Eucharistic Adoration Vigil. So please, I encourage you to take part in this beautiful and powerful devotion to make reparation to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. There is a sign-up sheet located in the vestibule, and I want to thank all of those of you who have already signed up. The sign-up sheet will tell you, so some people want a silent hour, so it'll say which ones are silent. Usually those are the ones after midnight, and then the ones in which I might be saying a prayer to the nine choirs of angels, or there might be the Rosary, Divine Mercy Chaplet, etc. But it really is a beautiful thing, and I encourage you personally to look into doing this. If you haven't already done so, I wish to remind all of you to register again for the Catholic Life Conference. It is fast approaching. Do it today, please, because time flies, and you know we get caught up in so many different things. Stations of the Cross are being prayed on Fridays of Lent after the 5:30 Mass. So we'll be doing this coming Friday. We'll have Stations of the Cross, and then we'll have the Exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. The 2020 annual Catholic Appeal is underway. There are some envelopes and brochures in the back of the church for you if you'd like to make a donation. Please take time to read the brochure. You can make a gift online or using the envelopes here. Again, I want to stress that 100% of what you give, you can earmark, and you say, I want 100% of this to go to, you know, to any ministry that you want. Alternatives, you know, Rachel's Vineyard, the Tribunal, whatever. None of it goes to payouts for legal criminal cases. So don't worry about that. You know, what benefits the diocese benefits us, because we depend on the diocese for our existence. So please consider it, pray about it, and thank you for your generosity. There is still time to join the class on the Creed, as Teresa Cologi is offering on Saturdays this Lent, although she may be changing the time. So there's more information on the bulletin. Okay, so thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.